On the 10th of March, 1965, two Indonesian KKO Marines arrive in Singapore on a covert mission. Their names are Osman and Harun. They are armed with explosives. Their mission, to blow up a large-scale building in Singapore and cause as much damage as possible. Osman and Harun search for locations throughout the day and find just the right place on Orchard Road. Once they've decided on their target, Osman and Harun, who've been training for months, work fast. It takes just moments to place the deadly bomb inside MacDonald House, and they disappear down Orchard Road. Twenty-three-year-old student Kenny Yeo was taking his usual afternoon route home along Orchard Road.
走的时候看到那个大厦的电梯那边有那个白烟出现，我就好奇，一转身看的时候呢，这个炸弹就爆炸了。
According to experts, Osman and Harun had selected a near-perfect target. Professor Widodo is a leading authority on Asian architecture and heritage.
MacDonald House is, at that time in the 60s, is one of the most iconic buildings in Singapore. It's high-rise, has very high-class design and interior, and it's considered as a very prestigious estate in the city. So I think that prominence make these buildings an interesting target.
Osman and Harun's bomb was placed with deadly accuracy, and it caused maximum carnage. The 25-pound bomb ripped a 2.5-foot hole in the floor. It smashed through the bank's correspondence room and blasted out support pillars from the first four floors. The explosion tore up the elevator shafts, wrenching out all the lift doors. There was just as much carnage in the street outside. The falling debris and glass pounded the cars along the road, and every window pane within 100 yards shattered. Two secretaries of the Hong Kong and Shanghai Bank, Juliet Goh and Elizabeth Susie Chu, died instantly. Elizabeth's six children became orphans overnight. The third victim, Muhammad Yasin bin Kesit, who worked for the Malaya Borneo Building Society, died after being in a coma. He left behind a wife and eight children.
This 那么医生，我叫医生从别地方割那个皮来补后面的皮，就是一直很惨痛了，很惨痛，就在我的也睡在我的旁边，大概三天这样子。For
the bomb survivors, they were left with deep psychological scars that would never heal.
那时候有大概25个轻伤，8位是重伤。 那么三位死亡，所以大概有在这次的遭难36个人了。那么我就被到中央去，就在那边动手术。 根据我们医生动手术以后呢，开一个小小会议的时候，我们觉得在一线之间呢，就说你的生命，孩子的生命在一线之间呢。他说那个医生说，除了祷告上帝之外呢，可能没有什么，我们不能够做什么了。
Kenny Yeo survived, and he was left to pick up the pieces of his shattered life.
大概动了七个钟头的手术，把我身上的玻璃，能够拿出来，那么我的眼球也炸出来了，那么身上数了，大概医生在我身上缝了366针。当医生一面拆我的白布的时候，我心里面很难过，一直想哭，为什么呢？以后我就瞎子了。